Hello guys, Steel here. Welcome to another episode of SD Gundam G-Generation Genesis playthrough. So last episode we just started the Stardust Memory series, starting with the Afterglow of Solomon, where basically the GP-02 was stolen and it's about to be sent to space. Luckily our team right here with Ko and South Burning and etc. and the rest are stopping them, and let's see where that goes from now. So we are gonna go through the sands before launching in the HLV after all. But yeah, let's go. Since the shuttle plan didn't work out, they'll be forced to go to a place with HLV. それは核弾頭装備のガンダム2号機であった。ガンダム開発計画によって生まれたこの機体は南極条約によって禁じられた核兵器を有しており、それだけ。Yeah, as to why they built that in times of peace, supposedly, we don't know. Well, we've seen this guy back in Rise from the Ashes, since he is stationed in Australia.
アフリカ方面に移動していることまでは分かったが、問題は奴らの宇宙への脱走を阻止したのが裏目に出やせんかということだ。まさか奪った核をジャブローに向けると指揮官は常に最悪の事態を考慮に入れねばならん。南極条約は当てにできる立場でもなかろうしな。
Then why build it? Back in the desert. Well, Sydney is supposed to be a dry land now, after Operation British. And we've been there ourselves in Rise from the Ashes too, in African desert. And this surely is not a place where the Phantom Corps, Phantom Sweep Corps can just go to.
アルビオンはガンダム2号機を追い求め出撃する。灼熱に立ち上る影楼の中に敵は潜んでいる。その危機感はアルビオンのクルーの焦りを誘い、そしてそれが不協和音となって響くと、ジオンの亡霊は再び目覚める。
Okay. Core fighter to Albion. Area is clear, requesting permission to land. This is Albion. Prepare for stowing. Roger that. Is that a saberfish or what? I'm not very familiar with a lot of core boosters. Well, it is a core booster. Looks like Uraki is back, and these are our vets. Empty-handed, I bet. Yeah. Alright, Ensign Uraki. Yes? Is it true what they say? Did you really fight the Nightmare of Solomon? Or did you get scared and hide under a rock? Excuse me, I'm in a hurry. What? Too busy to talk to peons like us? Figures. You're the hero who fought the Nightmare after all. I had help, Lieutenant Burning and Nina. If I'd been on my own, then... Ho-ho, then what? Then I'd be dead. I'd be dead, alright? That's not true. You saved yourself. Nina? I've seen the data from Unit 1. You handled that machine as if you'd been piloting it for years. Really? Yes, Lieutenant Burning and Captain Sinapus think so as well. Heh. You may be a crap pilot, but you know how to charm the ladies. Lieutenant Monsha, I understand you are frustrated at our lack of progress in finding the target, but I do not like men who lack self-control. Well, 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 there it is. What, you don't like me? Say it ain't so, Nina. Let's go, Ensign. Yeah, right. Don't run away from me, Uruki. She's really starting to hate you, Lieutenant. Shut up, you think I don't know that? Cripes, this waiting is torture. Gods be damned, Zeon scum. Where are they hiding? I'm really getting tired of pilots. I deserve more than this bull. Watch your tongue, petty officer. Oops, sorry. It's been a week now, and we're no closer to finding Gato. People are getting impatient. Even the scenery's lost its charm. Lieutenant Burning. Sir. I'm hearing too many squabbles and gripes. You don't need more fuel for the malcontents. Right. Sorry, sir. Got noon bitter right here. Welcome, Lieutenant Commander. We appreciate what you have done for the restoration of Zeon and for Operation Stardust. You are an inspiration to all us all, Your Excellency. You have managed to maintain this underground base for 3 years now. We lost many good men, and we only have a few mobile suits left. This base is built in the ruins of a diamond mine. We had to make many modifications, of course, but most of the structural work has been done. Yes, but thanks to Your Excellency's effort, we will be able to take the Gundam into space. I'm honored to serve the cause, Lieutenant Commander. Despite the difficulties, I knew that saving our last HLV would reward our efforts eventually. Indeed, if it were not for you, we would have had little hope at all. We do what we must in wartime. Now we need only wait for the launch window to have the HLV rendezvous with the recovery ship. Your Excellency. For the birth of the new Zeon. All security personnel, technician Orville of Anaheim is attempting to flee through the port deck zone. If he was a Zeon spy, Captain, you have my apologies. He was sent from Anaheim and our responsibility. You have no need to apologize. In fact, this might work to our advantage if it leads us to the enemy hideout. Captain, the core fighter launch port is opening. Damn. There goes our spy. Follow it. Tail it. Good. He thinks he's escaped. Petty Officer Simon, do not lose that core fighter's position. Yes, sir. Lieutenant Burning, launch mobile suits. Follow the core fighter. Understood. Monsha, A-Team, you take the lead. Yes, sir. B-Team, join Bait and Adele and hold position. Lieutenant, what is this? Monsha, you take Uruki and Keith. This isn't a sightseeing tour. This is life and death. Captain, what kind of formation is this? Lieutenant Burning is in charge of the mobile suits. I don't need a pair of wet-nosed rookies. Wet-nosed rookies? Well, don't worry, sir, we'll bring our own tissues. You think this is funny? Quit yapping and get moving. Alright, take us to the enemy's hidey-hole. Are those GM2 cannons or GM3? No, they're definitely not GM3. Probably GM2s. Everything looks the same out here. This is Blau Engel calling Kimberlite. Do you copy? I escaped from the Albion. Answer me, please. Well, it's an older model HLV, but it should be enough to get you into orbit. It'll be fine. I cannot thank you enough. Only one more hour to lunch. Excuse me, sir. What is it? We've had contact from Blau Engel. He escaped the enemy ship. The Anaheim Tech Orville? Ignore him. We don't want the enemy finding us. Roger. No, wait. Even if he don't reply, he could still find us and bring the enemy with him. This is unfortunate. We have to send out the mobile suits. If we lose them in this fight, this base will no longer have any reason to exist. But it is our will that Operation Stardust succeed above all else. We must buy time until the HLV can launch. Sir. There they are. I knew they'd come for me. Too late. Come to destroy you. Wait, what? No, stop. That's what you get for being dumb. But there they are. Managed to find them. Huh. Come on, you aliens. I'm ready to play. Sir, shouldn't the term be space noids? Sorry. Listen to me being rude. Lieutenant Monja, I've got contacts. Enemy units. Definitely a prologue stage. I think we're surrounded. I guess they baited a trap. They've left us no choice. We'll just have to return to the Albion. Rookies shouldn't talk like they know anything. Listen up, Rookie. Blast a hole through them. But what? Are you trying to get him killed? He's in a Gundam. It's the best machine we've got. What's wrong? Baby needs a diaper change already? Then get out of the Gundam so I can fly it. Or do you want to surrender and head it over to Gato personally? Ensign Uruki, going in. Bernard was an asshole, but I know he gets better. From what I remembered. Unfortunately, the enemy didn't want Orville. They must have shot him down so he wouldn't lead us to his base. Which means Orville must have had some idea where the base was located. And so, the base must be near where Orville first ran. It's the old diamond mine. There we go. That's it. Their base must be in there. Some large crater right there. And there goes the HLV. An HLV? Oh, so it's not going to be a prologue stage. It's going to be one of those separate maps. They're trying to take Unit 2 into space. Prepare for ground combat. The Albion is going in. Captain, are you sure that's... We have no choice. They're trying to buy time. The launch window must be closed. That HLV could launch at any moment. And when it goes, the Gundam goes with it? Exactly. The HLV must not reach orbit. All units, concentrate fire on the HLV. Alright. Some Zakus, some Desert Dom 2s or Dom Tropen Deserts, and Zaku Cannons. Definitely not gonna be a breeze. We got a custom Zaku 2. Alright. I'm gonna keep at it with our reserve squad and the blank rival. Okay, we just have to. So it's more associated with the other side. Not surprised there. Let's just hope it doesn't end up bad. Actually, I'm gonna focus on that side first. Hmm. You start tackling the bottom. Let's see if Ko has good accuracy. Oh, he has good accuracy. Evasion? Tankiness? I'm not sure. Probably gonna tackle or attack this guy first because he could only use a machine gun back. The bazooka really hurts, I know that. Damn, so hot-blooded. Okay, at least it deals a lot of damage. And Bernard Mancha has the leader aura. Should be fine. We could intercept the other Dom. Let's just hope. Okay, good dodge. That was the dodge we need. We could keep going next turn. Alright, now for this side. Let's see. Are they gonna be tanky or not? Pretty sure they are. Mostly for this reserve unit. Where they're all weak still. See how much Hades. 7k on crit, so no crit means around 6k, 5.5. It's pretty weak. Definitely weak. Could give the slave wraith. Let's see. We could give it a chance step. We could. There we go. Perfect. Could perform support attacks. We can kill this guy for 3 attacks. And we're only missing Marvin in this case. Perfect, and then Pixie will finish it off. Just what we need to get rid of one unit. We could do the same really on this side. Or maybe it's not gonna die. I guess it will still die. One more kill. Or never mind. We'll go for the damage. You could definitely ask for help coming from the Albion. And look at that 95% hit rate. Some good stat units right here. We don't even have a deputy captain, but we have definitely have good navigation. Yep, definitely why we're having that accuracy. Barely, damn. Now we can give Marion, though, some kills. She needs it to level up. Oh, I'm stupid. I should just use an exam or something. Oh well. It goes to Nimbus. I mean, I'm pretty sure these guys can do better in getting rid of those. So I'll just have Nimbus jump into the Domtropin. Damage it as much as possible, as much as he could. Okay, we can start with Amuro. Let's gauge how much a shoulder cannon does. 6k, not bad I guess. I think it still needs damaging so we can finish it off, or maybe Huge can finish it off now with the long range. Let's just hope it hits. There we go. But it did not die. That sucks. Alright, so it's up to Ford to grab all the EXP he could. I have one for him over there. We can have Agar kill this one to get a better range from those Zarkus in the front. And I trust him to counterattack those Domtropins with a lot of damage. Alright, passable. Alright, rather than giving him the last kill, I'll just pass on the Baidun. Have him get, or have him damage that, so can have the others follow up. Pretty good range stats right there. Definitely good. If you can get a kill, you could cast an exam too, so let's see. Definitely not getting it. Okay, now he can. And I'm not gonna hold back on casting it, just so I can get rid of that Zeon, or that Zaku. Gotta make sure this one dies. Would be a shame on the other side. It was supposed to be a worse squad. That's his second, I believe, so I could cast one more attack. Perfect. To help the bottom side a little bit. I still have that aura, so still get support from the slave wraith. Just stand by. Slave Wraith can take a hit. Or not the Slave Wraith, I mean the Pale Rider. And I might as well send this to Huge. Okay, I need to do a lot of catching up since didn't get the kills they needed in the first turn. Alright, let's see what happens on the other side. I'm more worried about that. Okay, we got counterattacks here. Counterattacks in vain. We can have Moncha. Okay, at least this side is good. Yeah, as I was saying, we can have Moncha deal with that top area if things go right in coast side. We have no liberty to be dodging. We gotta finish this up real quick. But those guys are not attacking. It's fine, it's totally fine. If you get rid of the dumb trap and there's no threat. A dodge that we surely will need. Okay, that crit is well just what we needed. It's fine, it's fine. We don't need a defense support yet. Alright, this will be easy. This will be easy. We got 7 turns. So few. Okay, if Chuck Keith kills those 3 and Moncha. Actually, we can drag the battle. Okay, this is good as in the bag. Perfect. Okay, that side is good. Now, we could kill this Tropin. Get one of these guys. Hopefully the farther one. Now he has one chance step left and he can support Moncha now for these full HP dudes right here. Ideally the cannon hitting is good, but I mean, yeah, why not? Go big or go home. Yeah, there we go. Succeeded. One more. See if our luck can be pushed still. Right, perfect. Now this is the idealistic outcome. I'll just get rid of the last one over here. Okay. We'll have to worry about the others moving. That's as good as done. Could use this really. Have Luke move one more time and hit another Tropin with the snipe. Yep, I trust the Pixie to dodge every single thing. Surprised he managed to counterattack from my max range. Alright. Amuro can take hits, so I'm not scared if he can just keep going like this, get as many counterattacks as he can. With a shoulder cannon and twin beam rifle, it could do whichever range. Okay, now we got the FA. I doubt this is gonna die. Yeah, even that was too strong. Start working on the leader. That's how it should be, really. Good crit. Can get rid of him right now, really. With who? You can jump step via this Tropin using FA78. And that should be enough to kill it now. And our last bet, will we get a cutscene on an FA78 using a beam rifle? Guess not. That sucks. This is supposed to be his cannon mech as well. And it's just a recycle thing, so I don't see why not. Let's get one of these guys before we kill the leader. Maybe a beam rifle will do the trick. There we go. No, you cannot fight anymore. First of all, you have an outdated Zaku. Pretty sure after we do the conditions, they are gonna merge. Or that's what I think, at least. Like two maps, I mean. Or at least just have Monstrous team move into this map when the reinforcements do come in. The Albion can keep up. Okay, that's pretty much everyone here. Alright, no reason to delay this any further. And this is brain dead. We can just counterattack and we won't die. And we still have one more turn. Or maybe we can finish it right now with that super crit. There we go. Probably not a good idea. Since now we're gonna start an enemy phase, and wherever he starts and he has no HP, that's gonna be bad, but we're here. Let's just see what happens. Lieutenant, I'm not picking up any enemy contacts. See, you can do it if you put your mind to it. Not bad, Ensign Tenderfoot. You should go and help Albion. Sounds good. Uriki, Keith, stay on me. Roger. Let's just hope it's somewhere in the back. Of course you're still alive. No retreat. For the glory of Zeon, everything depends on the launch of the HOV. Enemy reinforcements? They are mobile suits. Damnation, where are Mancha and Uriki? In the back. Oh, this is not good. One Tropin hits and he's gone. Looks like we made it in time, Lieutenant Mancha. Listen up, it's time to get serious. We have to help the Albion bring down that HOV. You got that? Yes, sir. Okay, let's just hope they don't move yet. They usually stay on standby for one turn. Oh, shit. That's where the problem is. Let's just hope for the best. Damn, that was a bad idea. Taking way too many hits. Doesn't matter though. Oh, they're not aiming at me. Perfect. Probably because the cliff separates them. Or they can't reach via that cliff. Okay, we have 6 turns and we don't have a lot of mobile units, but we only have to destroy this thing by Anvil Gatto. I didn't even see it was by Anvil Gatto, but we need to up our game right here. Since I don't have my Zeon squad, we don't have a lot of mobile units. That ship is rich in mobile units. There's a lot of them in there. But part of the challenge. Pretty sure the Pixie can kill this one, and now he could jump start into the deep area where a lot of units are waiting, and he could pretty much dodge most of them, but I guess that plan is to be on hold. Let's get him to kill them. Let's make sure. Well, that's fine. Well, let's do it. Let's kill the guy and go deep in there. Finish up Pixie's supposed goal. Straight to the leader and to the HLV. These guys are really slow. So I'm gonna have them hitch a ride. Oh, how unfortunate. It's fine. We don't want to redock anyway. Okay. Still pretty weak though. Maybe we should start giving the Easy 8, the one that gives you higher base damage, the modification. Should have hit just a closer unit. Armor should be fine here. Wow, really dodged an 84%. Out of energy. At least we have one beam rifle left. And but no, not on that side. Supposed to be heading on the upper area. It's the only saving grace of this unit. Its beam rifle is actually farther in range. Just hope you make it. Barely not. We can disembark though. There we go. That's where SFS are useful. This side, oh, doesn't really matter. They actually regenerate me, so that's a good part. But one thing, we don't want them coming at me, so I'll just be on standby. But if they still do, oh well, but it's more trouble than it is relief. Oh, shouldn't have attacked that. Could have done a counter support there. So they are gonna charge in. Let's just hope the secrets go in the front. I don't want those EXP in vain, so we need someone, we need like a messenger to get rid of all those. Okay, at least these guys are going to the front area. And we have 5 turns, still plenty considering we're almost in the front of the thing. But one high mobility, or maybe we could send him an SFS and have him jump out. Pixie seems like the perfect candidate. Except that will spend the Pixie's turn if I do that. So it's best given to someone. There you go. Should die. The crit. Yeah, FA78 could be our messenger too. Just need to set up. Because now he's supercharged. Have Amuro help him a little bit with a shoulder cannon. Hopefully it hits. It does not. Still have one more shot, I guess, with the easy 8. There we go. And perfect damage. Just enough to kill it. And it doesn't matter if he loses his super tension when he gets to the back. They're all damaged anyway. So let us. And I'm not even scared if I get hit too much. It's a full armor. It's definitely tanky. Tankier than many of my units, though. Or still. Okay. Getting stronger slowly but surely. Slave Wraith. Sadly enough, it's not enough to kill. And that is your last stand, basically. For the glory of Operation Stardust. It's just what you can do. Taste some lead. At least they make it seem as if in the story, no helmet or anything, just like a test pilot. Just a test pilot, never was a pilot. Have the slave wraith over here. Maybe pick up that kill, so we can use offensive supports. Except we don't have units outside, so it'd be pointless if the slave wraith cannot do anymore. was in vain after all. Still have killed that last one though. And with Riders over here, we can do support attacks too. Try sniping that one as well. So he ends up jump stepping. I was gonna give it to Cherry, but that's alright. This way you can advance further. Work on those Dwaggy. Okay, really, we don't have to move all these units, but let's just see. Maybe there are more reinforcements, who knows? But as of now, why does Stardust Memory have so many big maps? Unnecessarily. Okay. Just hide for now. Just keep moving. Well, we could have attacked the HLV, but we can still attack it though. Pretty tanky for an HLV. Start working on this guy too. The master unit of course has 22k HP. And yes, the GM cannon is very tanky. Appreciated. It's not worth it. I'll just focus on dodging the next turn. For now, we can just go with the flow. And we can defend support, luckily, if we need to. What? I'm in trouble? Serious trouble. This is what I'm afraid of, losing it already, but it's fine. Better than not be able to dodge, which I'm pretty sure is, I won't be able to. Might as well deal that damage in return. Okay. Four turns, but we're right in front of it. Okay. Garbage. We don't have the XP boost on the Totus Ritter. We have two, except our masters are garbage. Why did I put them in the master? That's fine though. I could give it to Easy 8 with no energy though. Could use a chance step really. Or maybe just cast it from the ship. Could reach all these guys until the ground Gundam. Same with this, except I know we don't have it here. I didn't really fix that crew. So the best we could give, I think, is the ground Gundam. I'll just give it to it. So I have 8K HP. Almost 15. What? Are you serious? Nah, killing that. Still have my buff. I could have hit the HLV, but it's definitely regenerating. Gotta work on it now. We have the Mad Rock move. We don't have to move the others. Should we pinpoint it? Probably we'll end the stage. Not yet. 16 plus 28 is 44. Yes, we have enough. Okay, now you just have to kill 3 with our limited energy. Oh, for real? That means gonna be giving the Totus Ritter some XP. A lot of XP. And we ran out before we even finished. Totally fine though. We just wait. We could end this right now too. I mean, we could counterattack here. So I have the EXP boost. Seems like the perfect target, too. Not even 200 and already at 4 bars. This is gonna be weak later on. Like, really weak. That's the last of it, South Burning, don't worry. Got a Dwaggy. Still damage it though. Twin Beam Rifle. Or Twin Beam Gun. Oh damn, I killed it. This means we have to capture the other one. Damn. I was rushing, but that's fine. I mean, looking at it now, thinking now, I think we are gonna need a Dwaggy. I haven't seen a Dwaggy. I haven't at least put in the production list or even just normal. But do we even have salvage? We should have salvage. Master unit? Should have it. There we go. How convenient for you to have it right now. Perfect for one last shot. Now we're gonna be wrapping up with that HLV. But we both know he's gonna end up succeeding in launching anyway. This is just for game purposes. Damn, it's really tanky though. Okay, I'm gonna end up with the Mad Rock then. Wow, it still didn't die. Shows how much makes a difference, piloted by Gato. The enemy are closing in. We cannot allow the sacrifices to be in vain. Launch the HLV. Captain, the HLV is in firing range. Ready cannons. Lieutenant Pasarov, acquire targets. I cannot get a fix. There's too many or too much enemy fire. Are we too late? Yes, you are. Bye-bye. Another HLV down or up in space. Captain, the HLV. Ugh, we wasted too much time, or perhaps it was always an impossible mission. Okay, now we're gonna be heading to space where our Gundam squad is going to be having a lot of trouble as always, at least four of them. And of course, we got Huge on top. Just like how I want it. Going to be racking up those ace points. Okay, we got these guys. Well, we even got him. Moncha. Look at that look. Looking so dandy. Alright. That's it for this episode, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and make sure to tune into the next one. Operation Solomon will begin, Gato will throw in that nuke, and yeah, make sure to tune in and do all the fun stuff, like, comment, and subscribe. That is it.